Now, in the second part of this fourth lecture, we shall look at some interesting properties of this coherent states. I'm erasing, erase this part. Lambda A, lambda, this is an eigenvector of A, therefore this is lambda, 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 and this is simply lambda. But notice that lambda, this A operator is x plus ip over root 2. These are operators, lambda. So this is the expectation value of x in the state or in the wave packet lambda. So it is 1 over root 2. X lambda plus I p lambda, which I can call x0 plus ip0 over root 2. So, so that lambda is was a complex number, but it has a physical meaning because its real part is, except for 1 over root 2, is the expectation value of the x operator in the state lambda or in the wave packet lambda, and this p0 is the expectation value of p. So these states, lambda, we can also write x0 as x0 p0. And for example, for the unity completeness relation, for example, lambda r is x0 over root 2. Therefore, d lambda r is dx0 over root 2. D lambda imaginary is p0 over root 2. And d lambda imaginary is dp0 over root 2. So we can write this completeness relation in a different way. Namely, we can write it as, I will now let x0, p0 to be x and p, because they will be simply variables here. That's equal to 1, will be equal to 1 over root 2. Root 2 makes 2, so it is 1 over 2 pi dx dp, xp, xp, where this is p, this is x. So this is another way of writing it. And of course, these are the states in the phase space. All right. Now, before we computed in the last lecture, we computed, for example, x square in, and its matrix elements between the oscillator states. Okay. Now let us compute x square, p square, and the variances in the state lambda. So we begin. I am erasing this part. Again, remember, we are using dimensionless position and dimensionless momentum. All right. So x lambda will be lambda x operator lambda. Let me just write here quickly what these x and p's are. A is equal to x plus ip over root 2. A dagger is equal to x minus ip over root 2. Therefore, x equals a plus a dagger over root 2. And ip, the p will be minus I, a minus a dagger over root 2. So, this is equal to lambda. X is, I copied from there, a plus a dagger over root 2 lambda. This is lambda. This gives lambda star, is x on the bar. Bra over root 2 lambda lambda. And this is 1. How about x square lambda? So it is lambda x operator square lambda. So it is lambda a plus a dagger root 2 a plus a dagger root 2 lambda. So it's equal to lambda 1 half a square plus a dagger square plus a dagger a plus a dagger plus a dagger lambda. We want all the a's acting to the right and all the a daggers acting to the left, but the order is not right here. So to change it, we take the commutator. So a dagger is equal to a dagger plus the reverse order, a dagger a. So this is just 1. So this is equal to lambda 1 half a square plus a dagger square plus 2 a dagger a plus 1 lambda. And the result is trivial now. This gives me lambda square, lambda star square. So it is 1 half lambda square plus lambda star square plus 2 lambda star lambda plus 1 times lambda lambda. This is 1. And this is lambda plus lambda star over root 2 square, this part, plus a half, plus 1 half. But lambda plus lambda star over root 2 is just x lambda. So it is simply x bar square plus 1 half. I can erase this part, at least this much. So we have an x bar and x square average is x bar square plus 1 half. So x square average minus x square is x bar and x curly brackets are the same. X bar square plus 1 half minus the square of x bar square. So these things canceled 1 half. So this is delta x square, the square root is root 1 over 2. This is, of course, a bit surprising because of this. The state lambda, let me erase this. The state lambda is, except for this normalization factor, n lambda n over root n factorial, is composed of all these oscillator states, and individual oscillator states have delta x is root n plus a half. So for each delta x n, for the nth state. So except for the low state, which has square root of 1 over 2, there are all these infinity of states with higher. And yet for the this coherent state has this variance the same as the ground state. So that's surprising, or that's the interesting result of the coherent state. Okay, I am erasing this, and now we are doing the momentum. So P, the state lambda, is minus I lambda A minus A dagger lambda over root 2. That's equal to minus I lambda minus lambda star over root 2. P square lambda is lambda minus I square A minus A dagger over root 2, A minus A dagger over root 2 lambda. That's equal to lambda minus I square over 2. So I have A square plus A dagger square plus minus A dagger A minus A dagger A minus A dagger. But this is A dagger plus one plus A dagger A, and this is just 1. So let us just remember, I'm erasing the rest. This is delta x lambda. So lambda minus 1 half, then I have A square plus A dagger square minus 2 A dagger A minus 1. Equals minus 1 half lambda square plus lambda star square minus 2 lambda star lambda minus 1 times lambda lambda, and this is 1. Let me write this thing here. Delta x lambda is equal to 1 half. This is minus, it was minus I square, let me keep that, over times lambda minus lambda star over root 2 square, this part, plus 1 half. And what are we calculating? This is p square lambda. So this is nothing but the average p. So it is p lambda square, p lambda square plus a half. So delta p square lambda is p square lambda minus p lambda square. That's equal to p lambda square plus 1/2 minus p lambda square. So these things cancel. This is also 1/2. So delta p lambda is 1 over root 2. So this has the amazing erase this much. This therefore has the amazing property, although we have a complicated look at this wave packet, delta x lambda delta p lambda, that's equal to 1/2. So it has the minimum uncertainty, This was 1 over root 2. 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, it is 1/2, okay? This is 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, that's equal to 1/2. I am erasing this now. Now, let us, now that with lambda, we can associate it with the x and p, the real and imaginary parts, with the expectation value of the x and p operator, our discussion gets more physical. Let us go back to this localization. Let us look at localization in phase space. So here, let me take lambda to be x prime plus I p prime. Namely, x prime is the expectation value of the x operator if the system is prepared in the state in the wave packet lambda. And mu is x double plus I p double. Now, the overlap is e to the minus mu minus lambda square, e to the minus. So, this is x double minus x prime plus I p double minus p prime absolute square over 2. Here, sorry, I have 1 over root 2. So, a plus ib absolute square is a square plus b square. Therefore, this is equal to e to the minus x double minus x prime square over 2 times e to the minus p double minus p prime square over 2. That means if you are in the phase space x and p, and if you are at, for example, here x prime p prime, so if you have a wave packet whose x operator average expectation value of the x operator and the p operator are x prime and p prime, that it has an extent, it has a finite extent about this point. Because if you go away from x prime and p prime, the probability of finding it drops in a Gaussian way, exponentially. So these are localized, these states lambda are localized in the phase space, localized. So if you move about more than delta x, delta p, the probability of finding it will be get reduced sharply. So it's interesting. They are localized in the phase space, these states. Now, it is interesting to look at the time development of these coherent states. So this was just an application of this with mu and lambda, given their physical importances, the expectation values of the x operator and the p operator, and that we have a localized state. If you go further away, then overlap is zero. Now the interesting thing is to look at the time development. How does this coherent state develop in time? So the time development operator is e to the minus I h t over h bar. H bar is the dimension energy times time, h t energy times time. So. But we operate with dimensionless variables. Therefore, we wrote h in terms of e to the I, h bar omega, h prime, t over h bar. So it is e to the minus I omega t h prime. So let it act on the state lambda. So lambdas are just complex numbers. The operator will act on the oscillator states in the expression of the state, coherent state lambda. So we have e to the minus lambda square over 2, sum over n, lambda to the n over root n factorial, then e to the minus I omega t h prime acting on n. But n is an eigenvector of h prime, so n h prime will be replaced by its eigenvalue n plus a half. Let me just take this thing out. So it is equal to e to the minus I omega t over 2, e to the minus lambda square over 2, sum over n, lambda to the n, e to the minus I omega t, let me just write it also to the power n, and let me write this as n factorial a dagger to the n zero. So it is clear that lambda is going to lambda e to the minus I omega t. So let's check this one also. Lambda is going to lambda times e to the minus I omega t. E to the minus lambda square. So it, if I write it Here I have e to the minus lambda square. But instead of lambda, so let me call this lambda t. If I write it as lambda t, we see that lambda t absolute square is equal to lambda square. Why? Because e to the minus I omega t, e to the plus I omega t, they cancel. So they have the same modulus. So it is lambda t square. So we can write this thing as e to the minus lambda t square over 2, sum over n, lambda t to the n over root n factorial n again. And then I have this factor e to the minus I omega t over 2, which I will write as e to the minus I omega t over 2 times this lambda t state, lambda t. So the time development of lambda is that it lambda develops into lambda t. I have an extra factor here. Should this bother us? The answer is no. You can multiply any, this is an overall phase. The phase is multiplying this thing. So in any structure like lambda, lambda or mu, lambda, t, plus and minus will go away. I can put the into this definition, or I can keep it there, or I can redefine the energy scale such that if this is E prime, this is 0, 1, 1 half. So if I define it with E double, I can, that starts from 1 half, namely rescaling energy, I can get rid of it. But the thing is that it doesn't bother us at all, okay? So lambda t. So let me write this lambda t, the time developed version of lambda. Lambda t is e to the minus lambda t square over 2 times n lambda t to the n over root n factorial n. So what changed? Only lambda t, lambda went to lambda t, which we defined as lambda e to the minus I omega t. I'm erasing this part. Let's look at the phase space. Lambda is a complex number, therefore it is can be represented by a vector times e to the minus I omega t. Now, this is of magnitude 1, and it has a phase omega t. So it simply rotates the vector lambda in time t. So if this was at lambda, this is now lambda t of the same magnitude, but the phase has rotated like this, lambda t. Okay, so clearly lambda t has x t average plus I p t average over root 2, and everything, instead of lambda was just a complex number, whether it is lambda or lambda t, it doesn't matter. So all these things remain the same, namely delta x in lambda t is 1 over root 2, or let me just write this, delta x lambda t, delta p lambda t, that's equal to 1 half again. Now this is amazing. We have a wave packet, it is not dispersing, it is keeping its minimum uncertainty product invariant. It is just the same, whether it's lambda or lambda t. Now, something is very interesting. The thing to look at is here we wrote at the beginning x lambda. So if you write x lambda t, lambda will be replaced by lambda t. So let me just do that. I'm erasing. Before I go on, lambda t is equal to x bar t plus I p t over root 2. That's equal to lambda times e to the minus I omega t. Lambda is x zero, namely at time zero, average plus, or let me not check. X zero is the average of the x operator at time equals zero in the expectation value in the coherent state, times I p zero times over root two times this cosine omega t minus I sine omega t. Okay, so it is. So this is lambda. And this is e to the minus I omega t expanded. So let's read, equate the real and imaginary parts. Never mind, root 2's cancel. So xt is x0 cosine omega t plus p0 sine omega t. And pt is equal to the imaginary part minus x0 sine omega t plus p0 cosine omega t. It is obvious from the structure that xt square plus pt square over 2, that's equal to, if you just take the squares, cosine square, sine square, it adds up to 1. These squares add up to 1. But the cross terms will cancel. So it is equal to x0 square plus p0 square over 2. So the average energy at the beginning is, you have your wave packet or coherent state lambda. It has some average energy. And this average energy is invariant. This does not change. The average energy does not change, and the wave packet does not disperse. In time, it keeps its minimum uncertainty product. Is this here? Okay. So this is just like a classical particle. Not that we are writing them in dimensionless forms, but it's just those equations of a classical particle on a, and physically what does that mean? It is as if your quantum oscillator at time t equals zero is at the position x zero, and it has the momentum p zero. So you have pulled it to a position, and you are giving it a kick with momentum p0. From those initial conditions on, x and p are evolving in time, keeping the energy constant, but it is moving just like a classical particle. Now, one last thing. It is very interesting to look at this quantity. I am raising it. Let us look at x lambda t. Remember, lambda t is lambda times e to the minus I omega t. So I have 1 over pi, 1 over 4, e to the minus, instead of lambda, I'm writing lambda t square over 2, e to the minus lambda t square over 2 e to the root 2 x lambda t e to the minus x square over 2. And now I want to write x lambda t absolute square. So it is 1 over square root of pi. First, let's just square the real ones. This is real, this is real. So I have e to the minus lambda t square. Here I have e to the minus x square. These are complex. E to the minus lambda t square over 2. E to the root 2 x lambda t times its complex conjugate. E to the minus lambda t star square over 2. E to the root 2 x lambda t star. Equals 1 over root pi e to the minus x square minus, because I took into a minus parenthesis, these are positive. So it is minus, let me just write it like this, 2 x lambda t plus lambda t star over root 2. Then, do I have the square of this thing? We will check. Lambda t plus lambda t star square over 2. Let's check. First, the cross term. 2 lambda t star is 2 lambda t absolute square over 2. Okay, that's this term, the cross term. Then we have e to the minus lambda t square over 2. It's this one. And e to the minus lambda t star square over 2. It's that one. So we are almost finished. This is 1 over root pi e to the minus x minus lambda t plus lambda t star over root 2 square. But if you remember, what is this? This is simply lambda t a plus a dagger root 2 lambda t. This is just x, so it is x average lambda t. It is x t. So the result is very simple, finally. I can erase this. X lambda t absolute square is equal to 1 over root pi e to the minus x t average square. Yes, this is a big result. Now, let us discuss the physical meaning of it. First, it's a Gaussian, and a normalized Gaussian is 1 over root 2 pi sigma e to the minus x minus mu square over 2 sigma square. So here, sigma square, this is a normalized Gaussian. Here, sigma square is 1 over 2. Sigma is 1 over 2. So the result is this knocks root pi. There I have root pi. And this is gone. This is 1. Okay. And mu is simply xt, average. Now what does it mean? Freeze the time. Freeze the time. This is x. Suppose this is xt bar. Around xt bar, I have this Gaussian. Except that this is moving. Remember, xt, if I remember correctly, is x0 cosine omega t plus p0 sine omega t. So xt is also oscillating. Okay? It is going back and forth. So the wave packet is going back and forth. Where is it going back and forth? Here is the potential. And this is the energy. So this is 1/2, 3/2, 5/2. These are the, okay. So let me erase it. So there is some energy, and this energy need not be the oscillator energies. It can be somewhere in middle. The only thing limiting is that it is limited from below. It, you cannot go further below the, 1/2. Okay. So here we have an oscillator, oscillating wave packet. Without getting dispersed, all its phases have the same moving in tandem. So it is going and then coming back. Of course, there's there will be some penetration at the edges. But it is oscillating to and fro. So this is as classical as you can get for a quantum system. Now, let me just compare finally three cases in the phase space. So one is a classical particle. Classical particle. So this classical particle, let's just solve it. It's, well, if you watch the video Ideal Oscillator in the series, of introductory problems that that's on the web by Boğaziçi. You see that x double dot plus omega zero square x is equal to zero. Now I'm using with dimension. All this quantum stuff was we used without dimension. First, let me use with dimension. So x is equal to a, let's call it a cosine omega t plus b sine omega t. So at time zero, that's equal to a. And v zero is, if you take derivative, is the speed x dot evaluated at time zero. So it is omega b. So x can be written as, I will just write, x can be written as x0 cosine omega t plus b is v0 over omega, v0 over omega sine omega t. Let me multiply by m, divide by m, so that this is p0 with dimension. Okay. Now, in QM, we use dimensions. So we said let x be root h over m omega x prime and p m omega h p prime. So here we'll have root h bar m omega x t will be root h bar m omega x0 prime cosine omega t plus p0 is m omega h prime p prime 0 sine omega t divided by m omega. So if we just cancel this, divide by root h bar m omega. So m omega goes up, goes out of the square root. So m omegas cancel and h bar cancels. So in the in the classical case, if you write it in terms of dimensionless quantities, this is x0 prime cosine omega t plus p0 prime sine omega t. So it's just exactly the same thing we obtained. But there is one difference here. It is going around a circle. And you can check how it is going, because PT we obtained minus x0 sine omega t plus p0 cosine omega t. So for example, p0 was suppose p0 was 0, you started with at x0, so later pt is going down. So it is coming like this, as you can check, because lambda times e to the minus I omega t. So it is, what is this classical particle doing? There is only, we know where it is, we know its momentum, and it is going down with angular speed omega. So this is what the classical particle doing. If you start the classical particle oscillator, starting with the momentum p0 and position x0, it is going around this circle in the phase space. This is with the dimensionless variables, okay? Next, so this is what the classical particle does. Next, let us look at the representation of the of a quantum state, nth quantum state in the phase space. So what's that? I am looking at n lambda t. So it is e to the minus lambda t square over 2 lambda t to the n over root n factorial times, well, that's it. And n lambda t absolute square is e to the minus lambda t square to the power n over n factorial. And lambda t square is equal to lambda square, because the energy is conserved. And this was just the mean excitation, n bar to the n, over n factorial. So it is simply Pn n, Poisson Pn bar n. So if n bar is a large number, and it doesn't have to be millions, something like 10, 12, or something like this, the Poisson formula has a Gaussian limit. So it comes to e to the minus n bar square over 2 n bar divided by 1 over 2 pi n bar. So it becomes a Gaussian. Now what happened? What is the representation now in the phase space? Well, we don't have a point or blob rotating, and there is a time. There is no time. It is just that this is x and p, and for large n, this is sharply peaked. This is everywhere zero. If you look at for a continuous n, for example, except n is very close to n, so it is sharply closed at n bar. That means I have a circle, full circle, not a point going around the circle. I have a full circle, but there is some width to this circle. This is the representation of the state n, quantum eigenstate n, in this phase space provided by this coherent state. So it is so it's a Gaussian, but there is no time in this thing. It's just a thin shell in the form of a circle here, and between, let's say, n and perhaps n plus 1. So that's the representation. The important point is that no time in this picture. Okay, no time in this picture. No time. Of course, it has to do with this thing, that the energy of the eigenvector is defined. So energy time uncertainty says that we have lost the time in this game. So we have this circle. And finally, so this is the classical particle. This is the quantum state. Quantum state. And finally, now I can erase all these. XP again. We have a we have our part. Remember, for example, x lambda t square was 1 over root pi e to the x minus xt square. So in this case, we don't have a point like the classical particle. It is localized, and however, just like the classical particle, it is going around with the angular speed omega. So this is as classical as you can get in a quantum example. So this is oscillating in the potential somewhere, but depending on its energy, and this energy need not be one of the eigenstates, eigenenergies, eigenvalues. It is going and coming. Okay. Its speed is just like the oscillators. You know, it's getting larger and smaller and bouncing back. And of course, all these quantum effects like the tail penetration into the potential is there. It is not this dispersing. It's not getting wider. Its uncertainty product is the same thing as the ground state, even t, that's 1/2. It has the minimum uncertainty product, and it is localized in the phase space, and it is going around just like the classical oscillating particle with the angular speed omega. All right, this concludes our study in four lectures, the properties of the quantum harmonic oscillator in one dimension, simple harmonic oscillator. In this game, there is no forcing and there is no dissipation, and already it covered quite a bit of time. Thank you.